Good morning, 3PO. Are you on an exciting adventure?
I think you are.
He's
just sitting. He's just sitting looking out the front.
Oh, he's such a good boy.
Look at him. He's so regal.
He was actually excited to get in the car this morning. For the most part, he's just been like really freaked out. He's like, I don't know about this. And this morning, he was like, oh, okay, yeah, let's do this.
Well, it was his first night sleeping by himself. He was so excited.
Yeah.
For human contact.
He did really well, though.
Yeah, he did. I'm very impressed.
Oh, that will totally fit you.
It's so stylish. I don't know. Do we want him to be like teased at school because he's wearing Argyle? I don't know.
First day of school, new clothes.
You're doing it wrong.
All my plans.
That is not how it's supposed to happen.
We have a flawed system.
Blame Corrado.
Hashtag
blame Corrado.
Good enough.
Blame you for everything.
It's more of a blame Saskia situation.
What? Why?
I've put that thing up dozens of times. Okay? Uh-huh. No problems.
Okay, so then blame Mary, because she's the one who pushed it
yeah,
through
Mary.
All the way. Oh, man.
Thanks for this coffee, Mary.
Sheesh.
So I've decided to go camping in the backyard. I'm actually just drying everything out. The problem with camping during like the last weekend of the summer is that it tends to rain at least once. So when we packed everything up, everything was damp and wet. So we have to like hang everything to dry and hope that it doesn't rain because there's still a lot of clouds right now.
Airing everything out. Including the sleeping bags.
The ends like get wet because they touch the bottom of the tent. That's a normal thing that happens, but it was a damp camping trip. There was a lot of rain and damp air, so just airing it out.
He's exploring the wilderness because you know this yard is so wild. He really likes crawling in things.
Of course. It's been like 5 minutes, guys. Had to move everything inside. So now it's drying on this convenient railing. 3PO also came inside. He's like, guys, rain, get me inside now, rain.
You know what you should do? Camp inside. Tents in the living room, guys. Tents in the living room.
I'd be cool with that. It'll fit.
Oh, yeah.
It'll totally fit. For leaving the tent outside because it'll just have to dry afterwards. But it totally fit in the living room.
This is not helpful.
Oh, wow.
That's... Oh, my gosh. The tent's gonna blow away.
No! Oh, no! Somebody take this!
Continue to slip. Oh, I just stepped in water. Now yeah. I'm wet. Oh, my foot's wet.
This isn't fun anymore.
Good job.
There's puddles.
You have done the literal opposite of drying the tent.
Ah!
3PO, on the other hand, is hiding under the table because he doesn't like water. It's not that he's afraid of rain or thunder or lightning, he just doesn't like the water. So, how was your outside adventures?
We just did a nice fucking challenge again. We got nominated by Mother Nature. And yeah.
Oh man, it's coming down.
This is a thing that is happening right now. The gutter is overflowing. Saskia is sneezing. And 3PO is hiding.
I'm not just gonna hang out under the table.
Guys, I am having none of this.
Yep, none of it.
Excuse me, what are you doing?
Infringing on copyright?
What are you doing? I just put that back in.
Yeah.
I just put it back in.
No, you undid his hard work.
because he just spent the last 2 hours sitting in front of Corey and I, just ripping it out, and then getting tired and like laying down and be like, oh,
we just switched.
That was so much work. And then he'd like get up and see that there was still stuff.
Oops, I hit pause. I didn't mean to do that. I'm so very sorry. I interrupted your story.
Maybe. Yep. You did. It's fine. I'm done. It's fine.
No, please stop. Please. No, please.
Dog. Why do you insist on ripping it to shreds?
He just came back.
What
from
do
the
you
hospital.
Think?
We have to
doing?
Go back.
I just fix him. No, okay.
I praise him when he does it. When he like
when
tears
he rips
all the stuff
apart his toys?
Yeah, because one, it's in their instinct, right? It's in their instinct to just wreck
destroy
stuff.
Destroy things.
Yeah. And he's either gonna do it to that, like one, if we punish him, then he's being punished for his instinct, and that's not healthy. And two, I would rather him do it to his toys
that?
And praise him than he does it to stuff that's like...
He's got a beard!
You having fun there, Santa?
It's stuck on your face!
Santa Paul.
It's like his bottom jaw is inside the head.
The brains are the best part, creepy.
Oh my gosh.
We have spent the past 2 hours watching Michael Jackson videos. Where's Rihanna?
This is not Michael Jackson.
I know. I got distracted.
You lied.
Listen, so what happened is, okay, let me explain it to you. Danielle and I were just hanging out, the two of us. Carter and Saskia went out on a date, which is really gross. Don't do that. In the conversation, I forget who said it, but Danielle or I, somebody said the words caught up. Which to me reminded me of the Usher song Caught Up, so I put it in an Usher song, and then Danielle and I bonded for half an hour, 45 minutes, because we know all of the words to all of Usher songs. And she was shocked, because I'm a white man, and I know
not at all
words.
Not at all why
I'm
shocked.
Because I'm a white man.
Whoa. Not at all why I was shocked.
Shocked that as a white man, I knew all of the words to all of Usher's songs, and not just the most popular ones, but even the obscure ones. And then how did that lead to Michael Jackson? Oh,
because
we watched...
We were talking about how Michael Jackson and Usher... How Usher is the Michael Jackson of our time. And then we disagreed. And then we started watching Michael Jackson videos. And then it just, like, snowballed. And then it turned into a history lesson of Michael Jackson.
Rihanna showed up. And she was like, I didn't really know Michael Jackson growing up. Like, when he died, that was kind of... I didn't, you know... And I knew about, like the molestation stuff, you know? And I was like, you need to sit down. We need to watch, like, 30 Michael Jackson videos back to back.
I didn't know... Michael Jackson. I didn't know that Michael Jackson was a big deal.
There's no good way to
listen. I grew up in a very sheltered home. I didn't listen to a lot of like pop music, and so I had heard Billie Jean, but never really associated with a guy named Michael Jackson who was like the most famous man on the
That's
planet.
That's fair. That is fair.
So he died. No, okay, I remember. Sam and I were friends when we were teens, and I remember we were going to our house and watching Thriller. And we were like, this is a weird thing from the 80s. and then I remember everybody freaking out because he had died, and I was like, I guess he was important. And, like, I did not understand, like, the scale of, like, how important he was. 4 years passed, and, like, now I kind of get it more. But, like, the last 2 hours of just me, like, realizing, like, wow, if I had grown up with this type of music, I would have been devastated to lose this person.
Yeah.
And, like, just learning about, like, the way that he had grown up and, like, his influences and stuff. And it just made me really happy, but also really sad. Because it made me happy because, like, I feel like if I had known about Michael Jackson when I was a kid, I would have been like, he's just an old guy. And now I'm like, oh, wow, he's so cool. But he also had a really sad life. So it was, like, kind of sad. But also, he had some sick moves and stuff. Yeah.
Well, he was a huge, huge, huge influence. Like I don't talk about it much anymore because it seems, like, old and funny. But there was 8 years of my life that, like, I was into Michael Jackson, Justin Timberlake, and Usher more than I was into Star Wars. Like, I was, like, super crazy, like, super hardcore into dance.
Don't let the
like,
skills
like,
go.
I memorized the choreography from all of the music videos. Like, I would buy all the DVDs, all of the concerts, record stuff on VHS. Back in the day, I'd like wait for music videos to come on and record them and rewind them and watch them over and over and over. I haven't thought about it in a really long time. Like, you know, when Michael Jackson passed away in 2009, I made kind of my last dance video. I made dance videos in 2006 and then stopped on YouTube, and then you can still watch these. And then 2007, 2008, 2009, I didn't make any dance videos. And when he passed away, I had this file of me from a YouTube gathering called 789 of me dancing like Michael Jackson. And so I kind of waited a respectful amount of time. I didn't want to capitalize off of it. I waited quite a few months. And then in October 2009, I uploaded this video of me dancing like Michael Jackson. And people were like, make a how to dance video to this. And I'm like, guys, I haven't made a how to dance video in like 3-4 years. And the viewers were like, make a how to dance, I need to know. And I was like, okay, in honor of Michael Jackson, I will return and make one last how to dance video. And it's like widescreen and like high quality and like HD. And it's this like 40 minute long video of me teaching all of my Michael Jackson moves. And then I was like, and this is it. And then I'm done and I'm not making any more dance videos past that.
This is it, like the documentary.
That's it. So
it's funny because while we were all laying here, I kind of felt like me and Corey were just like remember pop-up video?
Yeah.
I kind of just like, because we didn't look up anything, but Corey and I were like, did you know this? Did you know that?
All the facts.
All the facts.
Yeah.
His whole history, his whole like legacy.
It was educational 2 hours.
Educational and very entertaining. Yeah. He's such a good dancer. And I was trying to describe, it's like, there is no one on the planet anywhere even close to the amount of fame that Michael Jackson had. Like Beyonce doesn't come close. Kanye West doesn't come close. You have to multiply it by 10 or 20 to be at the level that Michael Jackson was at. Like, he wasn't just really super crazy popular in certain communities. So every person on the planet knew exactly who he was. Even places where there is no English spoken, they were crying, screaming, fainting for Michael Jackson. It's insane.
That except Rihanna.
Yeah, except for me.
Everyone knew except for Rihanna.
But I learned during these 2 hours that apparently he really liked hanging out with kids because kids didn't know who he was and therefore didn't care about, like, fame. His popularity, and so they just treated him like a normal guy. So I feel like Michael Jackson would have liked me, because I had no idea who he was for most of my life.
And he had a really rough childhood, and people have different opinions about, like, the molestation thing. I've watched a lot of Michael Jackson documentaries, obviously not recently. My opinion would be that he didn't do it. I think he's somebody who's super, super disturbed and had a lot of issues. But his issues surrounding that would be that he genuinely liked spending time with kids because he didn't have his own childhood, because he was abused growing up, and because he really wanted to help people. And kids would treat him normally. They don't get how famous you are. They don't care. You can tell them, oh, he's famous, and they're like, I don't know, his place is fun. He has a giraffe. You know what I mean? Like, it doesn't matter. And I feel really bad. I think he was a super weird guy. I think he was super misunderstood. Once he died, all of the media was like, oh, everyone loved Michael. Everybody, he was the king of pop and he was adorable. I'm like, no, whoa, wait a minute.
Yeah,
like,
after tearing him to
You've hated him for 10 years at
ruined
least.
Him while he was alive.
Yeah.
And then once he's dead, oh, we all loved him. He was a gentle soul.
Yeah.
He was just misunderstood, but they
It's like, no.
Slaughtered him.
Oh, yeah.
Media, and like made him into this huge monster. And it's like, what? It's just so funny how like the tables turn immediately.
Oh,
they can capitalize off of it.
And he did a lot for the world, and he did a lot for charity, and his heart went out to kids, and not even just kids in the United States, but like, he is someone who really traveled the world and tried to help a lot of people, and is the greatest dancer to have ever lived. And wrote a lot of those songs himself. And just did incredible, incredible, incredible things.
I don't like this.
The dog? Or Michael Jackson?
He just moved and...
Oh, there's a phone. Look at that.
I thought we were bonding, but apparently I'm just the... You're just in the body pillow or something.
Yeah.
Thanks, bud.
Daily vlogs, I want them in my subscription box. I wonder who might drop by, even though sometimes it's Canada outside. So don't go away, we're here every day. It's not Apprentice A, it's Apprentice A. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, home is where the frog is.